So one of the things that happens in Exodus, Moses is leading his people through the desert. It's classic U-shaped story. They're in a tyranny to begin with, right? So that's the insufficient present. That's the old order. Then they cross the water, the destructive water. That's chaos, like the flood. Then they're out in the desert, wandering without direction. They start worshiping idols. They're wandering without direction. And then Moses goes up on the mountain, which is, by the way, what happens in Logan, just because if you're going to go see it, you might as well know that, because it's a journey up a mountain. He goes up the mountain and he gets rules revealed to him. Well, the way the story is structured is extraordinarily interesting, because Moses takes his people away from this tyrannical structure. But they don't go from tyranny to paradise, to the promised land, in one move. That isn't how it works. They go from a tyranny to absolute chaos, where everyone is fighting and killing each other and having a terrible time of it and half starving and having to pass through the Red Sea. Like, they go from tyranny to catastrophe before they go to higher order. And Moses doesn't even make it to the place of higher order. He dies before he gets there. So it's quite the catastrophe. And the Israelites are all confused when they're out in the desert, because even though they were in a tyranny and they were slaves, now they're nowhere and they don't know anything. It's not good. And so a lot of them actually start thinking about how good the damn tyranny was compared to wandering around in the desert, which is exactly what happened in the Soviet Union, right? In Russia now, there's huge nostalgia for the Stalinist era. So these stories, they're always true. They're always happening. So anyways, what happens to Moses is that the story is quite interesting. So the Israelites start to fight amongst themselves, which of course they do, because there's no higher order authority. And so then Moses sits and judges them, like literally like a judge. He sits for hours every day, and the squabbling Israelites come up and say, you know, he did this to me, and no, you did this to me. And so then Moses has to figure out who's right and who's wrong. And he's doing this for like hours and hours, for days and days, for weeks and weeks, for months. It's like the origin of English common law. It's exactly what happened with common law, because in common law, what happens is that you have all the rights there are. If you two have a dispute, you go before the judiciary, you sort out the dispute, that becomes a precedent. Now that's part of the body of laws. The body of laws is what you act out. That's why it's a body. Well, that's what Moses does. So he's sitting there making judgments, very, very finely tuned, discreet moral judgments. You know how difficult that is when two people have a dispute, to try to figure out how to mediate between that. You don't know who's lying, who's telling the truth. You don't know exactly what an acceptable solution would be. Like, it's really ridiculously hard work. So he walks through this entire process of continual judicial intermediation. Then he goes up the mountain, and what does he get? A tablet of rules. Well, why? Well, he spent his 10,000 hours investigating the structure of morality in a practical way, and it goes bang, this is what we've been doing, these are the rules. It's not like there's no rules to begin with and those are imposed, because that wouldn't work. It doesn't work that way. You have to take how people are, extract out what the pattern of what they are is, reflect that back to them. Well, that's the story of Moses, and it's a myth. It's a meta story. It's a story about how rules come to be. We act a certain way. We have certain kinds of expectations. We have certain kinds of disputes. Out of that, a patterned way of being emerges. Then we map the patterned way of being. We say, well, look, here's the rules. There's 10 of them, or however many you want to extract, right? I mean, it's a moving target in some sense. Don't kill other people, that's a bad idea. Don't steal what other people have. Honor your parents, etc., etc. I mean, these are, you could come up with a different basic set of rules, but there'd be some overlap, and those aren't bad to begin with. Of course, there were far more rules than that, but those were the central ones. And so then you might say, hey, if you took all 10 of those rules and you tried to extract out one rule from them that would be at the top of the hierarchy, what would that be? And in Western culture, the idea there is that do unto others as you would have them do unto you is the rule that, it's the meta rule that guides all other rules, sort of like the One Ring in the Lord of the Rings. And so it's this consistent pattern of abstraction of ethical guidelines.